Come here, Fontaine. Everything's going to be all right. I promise.
Yeah, right.
But just remember, when in doubt, all you have to do is sing the national anthem.
The lights at? Can't find nothing. What the hell did she put in my pocket? Man, I'm Stevie Wonder now. I can't see nothing. Well, what is this, a door? Yeah, I guess so. Yeah. Man, what did she say to me? When in doubt, sing the national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the singing of the national anthem.
Oh, Betty, I got to tell you, baby, I'm in doubt.
Ha, say. Can you motherfucking see by the dawn's early motherfucking light what surprise we hail at the twilight? Let's got them gleaming whose broad stripes and bright motherfucking fucking streaming and the rockets red motherfucking glare, the bus bursting all up in the motherfucking air, get through the night that the goddamn flag was still there. How say does the head star spangle motherfucking banner yet and where or the land of the free and the home of the motherfucking brave. So you dug the way I sang the national anthem?
Yeah.
You did? See, I've been trying to get the goddamn Lakers to let me do that shit when the season over. They keep saying no, they got Pizzadora. I keep telling them, bitch don't know the words to the song. You know, but I'm trying to retract my attitude now, because I can't be saying stuff like that, you know, since I just straightened up. I just got out the Bette Ford Clinic, you know. That's right, man. Me and Bette, we tight, you know? But I'm telling you, bitch gave me a little bauble to take with me and shit. She calls me Tane. I call her Bette. It's very hip, you know? And it's, you know, you'd be really surprised who you find at the Bette Ford Clinic, man. I'm telling you, all kinds of motherfuckers show up. Mr. Ed was off in the corner talking about Wilbur. I said, oh, shit, you know? And Renton Tin's all fucked up behind Lassie, you know? Because Renton talks about Lassie like a dog, man. See, I knew the bitch when her name was Spot. I said, ooh. You know, so I've been talking to Bette, you know, because I have been loaded since 62. And I felt it was time to clean up now because, you know, there's a lot of kids out there and they talk to me and say, Tane, you know, we've been listening to what you got to say. And I just figured it was bad for me to be high when I said it. So there's all kinds of stuff you can catch now, you know, so they want you to start rinsing your needles, which of course I'm really into. That'd be my luck to dip that shit in some Clorox, shoot it up and turn white as a sheet. Yeah. So, you know, I figured it was time to clean up and shit, you know, so that's what I did, man. And I had a hard time with it, you know. I told Bette, I said, look, how can I handle this? Because it's a different world. She said, look, Tane, what you got to start doing is watching the TV because that will tell you what's going on, you know? And I thought that was sound advice, so that's what I did, you know? I started watching on Sunday morning, which really fucked me up, you know? Because I tuned in first to this Jerry Falwell dude, you know? And remember, I just straightened up, so this shit is new to me. I see a guy walking around, looks like he got a log up his ass, and he's pointing at people talking about, oh, you messed up and you messed up. You know, and then I'm looking at it, I'm thinking, why am I straight now? You know, if this is what's happening. And then I checked out Jim and Tammy, what the fuck is that all about? You know, and I was really moved by Jessica Hahn, you know. Oh no, man, I was, you know, cause she ain't no slut like Donna Rice, you know. Jessica, I'm telling, hey man, am I lying? Did the bitch fuck up the election or what? Come on. Start checking it out, you know, and I thought, man, Jessica Hahn really got a raw deal, you know, because when you read about her, she said, Jim Baker, he ravished me, and he ravished me, and he ravished me, and then he left the room for 6 hours, and when he came back, I said, when he came back, bitch, what was you still doing in the room? It's just because I straightened up. But it seemed very strange to me, you know that? It hasn't fucking hurt her though, you know? She got a new gig, you know? She's looking good. She got new tits and new nose. But she says her lips are her own, you know? Interesting, you know, but and the scary part for me in looking at this whole thing with Jim Baker was the idea of him fucking anybody. Listen, for me, I'm sorry, but the idea of him over me getting ready to come is too much. You know, but then you look at Tammy and you sort of have an idea why he'd fuck a hole in a donut. Very strange, you know, and then she's crying all the time, always upset about, oh, Jim, 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 you know, and that's only because she got hold of, you know, some information, because she found out about Jimmy Swaggart, found out Jim had this much on Jimmy, and figured, you know, found out she got beat, you know, and Jimmy, so I mean, now Jimmy Swaggart, man, this is a man who didn't even have a penis before 7 months ago. I mean, if you had asked him, no, it didn't exist, there was nothing there. See, but it developed when he met a $20 hooker named Debbie. Now, I think Debbie was overcharging based on these pictures in this magazine, you know? And they're really radical, man. They're radical shit. I mean, this chick's got more hair on her ass. I mean, really, check it out. I mean, look. You know, and here's a picture of her with a curling iron with the shit going on. Scary, scary stuff, man. You know? And these are the cats that are running the minds of America. I mean, look at that shit. You know? And you start wondering about these cats. This motherfucker walks around with a big-ass baseball bat living in a glass house. See, now maybe it's me. But I think that's kind of strange, you know? But not as strange as oral. See, I want Oral Roberts' gig. I want to be able to say to you, give me $8 million because God said he's going to kill me and have you write a check. See, I think that's a real lucrative gig. And you turn around, you fuck up the $8 million and say, God said to give me some more and have you do it. You know? And what was on his mother's mind when she named him? It's a question you should ask yourself, you know? I mean, but it's very peculiar, don't you think? The cats are talking about religion, got all this bullshit happening, false prophets and such. Because you can always tell when God is talking. God's real clear. He's got those commandments. Doesn't matter what religion you're in, the commandments are the same. Don't lie, because you ain't never going to remember the bullshit you said the night before. Don't fuck your neighbor's wife, because you're going to be mad as hell when he's fucking yours. You know? Honor your mother and father because you're gonna need child care soon. Simple, you know? Simple shit, you know? And yet you look at these guys and you see that they've missed the whole point because God is real cool, you know? I like God. God's pretty funny. Platypus, think about it. It's very odd, you know? Very odd. There's a sense of humor there. You know, and a couple of neat things. You know, the one thing that I liked that God said was, you know, he who is without dog shit on your sneaker, take the first step on the white rug. See? I mean, you know. But see, these guys don't think about this shit before they go running out and pointing a finger at people. These, you know, zealots are scary. Zealots get you in deep shit like the Crusades, you know? Get you fighting over a piece of land that nobody's got the fucking deed to. You know? And what religion is better? Ask the English and the Irish. See, religion to me is like a sanitary napkin. If it fits, wear it. You know, so I'm looking at all of this, having just straightened up, you know, and I start wondering, who's running shit, you know? Because there's a lot of bullshit going on, man. I mean, maybe to you it's normal, but I find it very strange. But not as strange when you think about it being in America. See, America's very hip that way. We have very interesting ways of dealing with shit. You know, we're flexible, we change our minds. We're a good quality thinking nation. Oh no, we are. When stuff pisses us off, we go off. Ask Jimmy the Greek. You know, shit pisses people off. Yeah, Jimmy messed up. Pissed a lot of people off, right? You can talk to me, it's okay. Jimmy piss you off? Yeah. Huh? Yeah? Why? Yeah, I'm telling you. What did Jimmy say that was nasty?
Oh.
I mean, let's examine it, okay? Let's talk about it. Now, you got to remember, I have to preface this by explaining that Jimmy's old. You know, Jimmy's like 70, 80. These guys, they got their own way of dealing with shit. They go out to lunch, spend 6 or 7 hours having 18, 19 martinis. That's how business is done. You know, that's the old school. So you figure his first mistake was talking to a reporter, because they will fuck up everything you said. Okay? So she gets him across the table. She said, Jimmy, can you tell us why there are so few, how shall I say, black coaches? And Jimmy said, because don't nobody want them. See, they need to be there, but the field is sort of closed to them. And they need to be there because the white guys are getting lazy. Now, if you start to watch a little bit of sports, you may find that there's some validity to that statement. We watch white coaches on the field all the time. They look like this. But you see a brother on the field, get your goddamn ass over here and smack the shit out of you. So there might be a little something in what it says. But then she turned around, she said, Jimmy, can you tell us why there are so many, how shall I say, black athletes? And Jimmy said, because that's what there is. That's the way it's been set up. That's how it's been from the beginning. We brought big black bucks and bred them to big black gals. They made big black babies. Who was fast? Now, where is the offense? What's offensive about that? It ain't a lie. He told the goddamn truth. What happens to you on network TV when you tell the truth is, whoop, you gone. Faster than a fart in a dust storm, Jimmy the Greek was out of there. You know? I myself tend to think it's because he didn't have enough hairspray in his hair. You know, it wasn't hip enough, didn't have the right kind of style and patter to do the sports. So they got him out of there, and America was happy. I mean, the NAACP probably came. Oh, yeah, Jimmy the goddamn Greek. Get him out of there right now. All the brothers talking about, I'll kick his ass, man. And all the white folks saying, oh, Jimmy shouldn't have said that. Yeah. But he told the truth. You know, he didn't bullshit. And America, I wonder how long it'll take, see, to let that pass till Jimmy is okay again in the eyes of the country. And it's interesting how quickly we forget shit like Nixon. He's going around the country on a speaking tour, speaking about foreign policy. I said, excuse me, but aren't you the motherfucker brought the country down? You know, maybe it's just because I straightened up that it seems so goddamn strange to me. Ollie North got a book outselling the goddamn Bible. I said, wait a minute, did you break the law? Aren't you the lawbreaker? See, if I had passed any kind of secrets or passed some money or passed anything in this country, my ass had been behind bars. But see, as long as it's sanctioned by whoever it is, it's okay. And America says, fine, we'll buy your book. We'll buy your bullshit. How much? You know? We're very forgiving. I mean, I found that when we forgave Jesse Jackson. What's she messing with Jesse for, man? Bad enough the motherfucker ain't gonna be vice president. Cause Jesse pissed me off, man. I'm sorry, it pissed me off. When he first shot out on the scene, he had a great rap. The Rainbow Coalition. It was a great idea. Everybody was gonna be together, see? We all were gonna be one people. I like that idea. I'm an old hippie. I think it's hip. You know? I do, because that's the world I want to be in, where everybody's equal. Except with Jesse, was everybody was equal except for the people in Hymietown. You know, I had a problem with that. You know? You know, Jesse has some friends whose name I'm not even going to mention. As a matter of fact, black this shit out. Because I don't want these guys coming to look for me, because these people... No, 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 man. See, you end up a grease spot and nobody knew where you were. But then Jesse came back. He didn't have any of those folks with him. He wasn't talking about the Rainbow Coalition. You ever seen those dolls in the back of cars that go like this? Give me the baby to kiss. You know? And people saying, why you fuck with Jesse? He's a brother. You ought to be behind him, giving him all your support. He's the brother. I said, wait a minute. White folks always vote for white folks. Of course, they're white folks. It doesn't fucking work. You know? I get people blowing me shit about Sharpton, Reverend Sharpton. I wish this man would curl up and go somewhere. Cause even if somebody messed with Tawana Brawl, it don't fucking matter now, cause ain't nobody paying attention. See, So I have these thoughts going through my head, and they freak me out. You know, they do, because when I was high, I didn't care. See, give me nuclear arms. If I can shoot up in them, I'll take them. But no, I wanted to be straight. So here I am like this. You know, looking at America through clean eyes. What a fucking deal. You know, what an idea, being straight. And looking at America, which is a great place to be, let me tell you, I've been other places. I've been places I couldn't hide. You know, where I couldn't go to the, like, countryside and hang out with the farmers if somebody was looking for mine, you know, because they'd find me. I was easy to spot in Poland. You know, East Germany, ja, da ist es. Kommen Sie hier. Picken Sie us. I mean, so I'm glad to be able to be here, because when America heats up about something, it's fantastic. It's like heaven, man. You know, we saw that with baby Jessica, right? You remember baby Jessica? You know, baby Jessica fell in the hole. She did. She walked around, fell in the hole. I didn't push it, the bitch fell. You know? And baby Jessica hit the bottom of that hole, and America went catatonic. Cat-o-fucking-tonic. Everything on TV stopped. CNN had the baby Jessica second, the baby Jessica minute, the baby Jessica hour. Everything stopped. Motherfuckers was pulling up on the freeway talking about, have you heard about baby Jessica? You know? They went berserk, you know, because America had found something everyone could band around. A child in danger. And it got very hush hush in this country as we watched the visual of baby Jessica. And when they pulled that baby up out that hole, I, for one, was very happy because regular programming was back on the show. Very happy. You know, and I was happy too because baby Jessica was safe. You know, because it could have been my kid, could have been your kid. That's what got people going. What'd you come? Are you okay? Where you been smoking before you got here? You all right? Is she like that all the time? Well, she must be fun in bed. Shit. You know? Because that's what it's about. If you can't lay, she just slapped and said, don't you tell him that. You know? And I mean, they pull this child up out of the hole, you know, and we were happy. We were very, very pleased. And she got to the hospital, and this baby had more shit than any one child could ever have. Toyota trucks, toys, clothes, everything you could possibly want for your baby. And she got a telegram from the White House saying, baby Jessica, I'm very happy that you're okay. You know, because you're an American citizen, and I'm the president, so voila. You know? Ronnie Reagan. And see, that was very hip. You know, that's what they're supposed to do, because it meant, now think about it, if you were the parents of this child, you live in a small town, and the president of the United States is so glued into what's going on that he sends a telegram to you. Now think back before the president became the asshole, when presidents meant something. Now think of what that must be like to get a telegram from the president, okay? Talk about your kid. It's a wonderful idea. Now, Nancy, on the other hand, anorexic bitch that she is, you know, I don't like her. See, I think she's living in an unreal world. You know, this is a woman who probably had nothing to do. You know, all the first ladies are supposed to be together with their president husbands, right? And poor Nancy, she didn't know what the fuck to do. I don't know what I'm gonna do. You know, somebody said, Nancy, shit, do drugs. And of of course, she misunderstood. She's a woman living in an unreal world. Explain to me how you tell an urban teenager who lives in the street, in the school systems of the real world, just say fucking no. Explain it to me. How do you justify that to a mother who's maybe got six kids and $365 a month from welfare, and one of her kids is bringing 15 grand a week? Oh, just say no, fuck you. Smell the flowers, lady. You know, I mean, it's easy to just say no in the fucking White House. Okay, but it doesn't realistically gel. Because you get killed with a Uzi. You know, these 14-year-olds, they don't give a shit. They just shoot you. Narc. Gone. You know? So I don't like this lady. And I didn't even like her more because she didn't even go buy a Baby Jessica nothing. She went, and she didn't. She went in the closet and said, get Baby Jessica this. You know, she gave her stuffed animal, you know? Bitch could at least gone to Toys R Us or something. You know? I know, but she didn't, and that's okay. But America's outpour to this child was phenomenal. And I'm telling you, the saga ended like a Busby Berkeley movie. Baby Jessica's safe. Baby Jessica's okay. You know? People sent tons of telegrams. You're okay, thank you, God. You know? And it was wonderful, and it was good. It's unfortunate that the other side of the coin is the Ray brothers. You know who the Ray brothers are? They're the little boys, hemophiliacs, three of them. And they got AIDS through a transfusion. They got bombed out of their house by people they knew, the neighbors, you know? The neighbors bombed them out, fear, see? No telegram came from the White House saying, according to me, your president, this is un-American behavior, and I'm gonna let everybody know we're not gonna handle the situation this way. Nothing came from them. No acknowledgement. Now, see, maybe it's because I just straightened up. You know, maybe why I find it so odd. The fuck was that? You know, I gotta be careful what I say, man. National TV. Fontaine found stuffed in ashtray. Reagan fingerprints found close by. You know? I mean, it's, you know, nothing came from it. I found it odd. Because these are kids who know they don't have long to live. And I didn't understand why the president didn't at least cushion it. Say, yeah, okay, it's not my thing, but I'm sorry you got it. I'm gonna let him know. No, nothing. But then it shouldn't be a surprise when you look at how the AIDS issue's been covered. Their disease. Who are they? Homosexual. See, y'all got too many labels, so I'm just gonna lump you tonight. Folks. Okay? I'm gonna refer to you as folks. Now, people have a tough time dealing with folks. We find that Jesse Helms, of course, has a real tough time with it. You know, because there's like a booklet out that they want to give to kids to give them information on AIDS in ways that they might be able to prevent it, like using condoms or abstaining, or if they happen to be special folks, the ways that special folks can find to make special sex. Okay? Okay? Now, Jesse Helms says, no, you can't give this to kids, because once they read it, they're gonna start practicing special folks stuff. Which made me ask, well, Jesse, who are you fucking and what's his name? Because I know you read the pamphlet. Or you ask these legislators, you say, well, how come they ain't put this much money trickling down? You know, they tell you, they say, look, it's election year, and we don't want our constituents to feel like we're condoning a lifestyle that we don't agree with. Now, that's okay, because people are entitled to think whatever they want. That's what's hip about being here, you know? So you allow them to think that. You say, yeah, okay. Well, how do you justify your non-commission, your non-commitment to a 12-year-old who's gotten it, who has no lifestyle? Then people want to go to lunch. Gotta go. I don't want to talk about it. It's being labeled as their disease. To this moment, it's still their disease. I find that interesting, because I know the disease don't give a shit. It don't say, oh, sorry. No, it doesn't do that. You know? So why won't you give kids the information? You can barely talk about condoms on TV. You know, you can do it on CNN. They got a great commercial with Ally Sheedy. Hi. I'm Ally Sheedy. And I want to talk to you about socks. If you're having socks, like, use a condom, okay? And if you're not, like, don't do it. And tell your friends. And tell them I said so. Have you seen this commercial? Has anybody seen? Is this not? You know, it's almost bad for me to say what a stupid commercial it is. It only is sort of like you can digest it until the last sentence. Tell them I said so. Who gives a fuck? Do it because you may die. See? That's the idea, because you can't stop kids from fucking. It feels good. It does. And if it doesn't, get a new partner. I've tried laying the heavy rap. I have a kid. I've laid the heavy rap. I said, don't you even think about having sex. I will sew you up. I will break your legs because it's a terrible thing to have. You don't even want to do that. And she said, well, you do. I said, but I don't. I think about it. You know, and I said, and if you do it, I'm going to slash you. And she looks at me and says, fuck you. You can't stop them. Say, but you can help them. First, by getting the information out correctly. Now, let us examine what it is that scares people about special folks. Okay, special folks have been around since air. Like they just popped up out of the blue. Alexander the Great was a special folk. What made him great? We know now. You know? I mean, think about it. God made the world, made some air. Threw some birds up there. Boy bird, girl bird, boy bird, girl bird, boy bird, girl bird. Boy bird and a girl bird got together and said, we're gonna make some baby birds. Two girl birds got together and said, not us. And the two boy birds got together and said, get a girlfriend. So, I mean, it's been around for a while, you know? It's odd that it could be traced to one people who have been around for thousands of years, when we in this country have wonderful laboratories which create elaborate germs to kill people. Elaborate shit. Shit that destroys people and leaves the building. Now, maybe it's me. Maybe it's because I've just straightened up and I missed something. But what good is a building if there's no fucking people? You know, and what is Agent Orange? Explain it to me. Feels like something that goes into the system and fucks you up. Now we have this incredible disease that will eat you on contact. And not even in a nice way. You know? You know, I put a sign up said by invitation only. It's real strange. It appears to me to be very strange, but not really. When you sort of look at how the country's reacted over the last several years about this. I mean, you know, nobody wanted to hear about it 8, 9, 10 years ago, you know? Nobody gave a shit. But then America's number one man's man got it. I mean, America's number one man's man. You know, I'm talking about the man who held America's three white women in his arms. Now, some of you may be thinking it's you because you're white women. You ain't. See, because there was only three. Doris Day, Donna Reed, and Hazel. White women. This man held Elizabeth Taylor in giant. Okay? And if you had said to somebody 20 years ago that this man might have had a relationship with another man, you'd have gotten your ass kicked. What did you say about him? I kicked your ass. Call Rock Hudson. I smacked the shit out of you. You know? You'd have gotten your ass kicked. That would have been like saying John Wayne fucked his horse. Crazy. People went nuts. So when it came out that America's man's man went in a different direction than America thought he should be in, the shit hit the fan. Now, what I think happened as far as us getting funding is what I'm going to relate to you. I'm not saying that I'm going to tell you fact. I am not saying this is fact. I just want you to know that, so that if you retell this story, you don't say Fontaine said on the Bible that this is how it happened. I'm only saying it could have, maybe, possibly, in a funny kind of way, come down like this. Okay? And what happened was the phone rang in the White House, and Ronnie picked it up.
Hello? Yeah? What?
Get the fuck out of here!
Rock, will you shut up, Nancy?
Rock Hudson. God damn.
Yeah, okay, okay. Now, Nancy, who's on the other side of the room, is standing there looking at him.
Well, are you gonna tell me what he said?
Yes, Mommy. Mommy, Rock Hudson, America's man's man, has AIDS.
What did you say? Did you just tell me that Rock Hudson had AIDS?
Yes, Mommy. Ronnie, you better sit down, honey. 'Cause there's something I never told you.
Ronnie, I fucked Rock Hudson.
Well, yes, Mommy, but so did I.
Saying it happened that way. Well, that might have been a reason we got a little bit of money. You know? But it shouldn't be surprising that it would take something like that to loosen up this flow of bucks from this guy. And I keep asking, how the fuck did he get here? Did nobody check his resume? Didn't anybody know he was the governor of California? You know? And everybody said, oh, I don't know how he got here. I didn't vote for him. And what the fuck? You know? Oh, nobody voted for him. But he's there. You know? Now, let's examine this for a second. I want to play a game with you, okay? You up for a game? How many of you are registered voters?
Oh, yeah.
Well, let's play a game. If you're a registered voter, put your hand up and keep it there for me, please. Okay. Now, how many of you, before the last election, had a beer or a joint or anything else, put your hands down? Now, I want you to turn around and look. Multiply yourselves by 50 states. And you wonder how the fuck Ronnie got to be president? How can you question it if you vote loaded? You see somebody smoked a joint and went in to vote? Have you got a banana or something? Is Ramsey Lewis running? Fuck it, I'm voting for Ramsey Lewis, man. You know? It's strange, isn't it, when you think about it? I guess I can't say much, you know, because you know I was in there talking about, yeah. Took me 2 weeks to vote. You know? You wonder. And I find it interesting that nobody checked this cat's credentials. But you can't forget, see, that the biggest problem, Mr. Reagan, is he does love the country. See, he's a real American and a real big union man. Oh, does he love the union? You know? Especially the air traffic controllers. See, who are now in the same fucking place they were before, except there's more shit in the sky to watch. Now, maybe that doesn't bother you, but let us think about what the scenario might have been when he met with them.
Hi. I'm Ronnie Reagan, and I'm running for president. You may remember me from 20 Mule Team Borax days. And you know, when I look at the great expanse of the American sky, I think to myself, it's you guys. You air traffic controls, mwah, love you guys. And you know, I know it's tough for you right now. You're not getting any help from Carter, that crab. But you know what? If you guys, you air traffic controllers, get behind me, I'll get behind you. Because I really believe that you control the backbone of the country. And I know that this is something you really want to think deeply about. Is my passport ready? Yeah. Maybe you don't care so much about the air traffic controllers. If you fly, you will. Because shit's falling out of sky. at an amazing rate, more and more. Over the last 8 years, things are literally falling. You know? Yeah, a lot of people are eating it. All these kind of things, they've changed. All these rules that they used to have. Yes, check the seatbelt. Check the nose of the plane to make sure there's no cracks in it. Fuck it, we gotta be there in an hour. You know? Maybe you don't care about that. Maybe that doesn't move you. But the farmers probably will. Because Ronnie loves the farmers. You're a farmer? I'm Ronnie Reagan. You know, you might remember me from the 20 Mule Team Borax days. You know, when I look out at the great expanse of the American byways and highways, I know that it's you. You American farmers that keep us going. And if you get behind me, I'll get behind you. I'll make sure that the fields are tilled, that the wheat is sown, and Bessie the cow gets all the milking she needs. So it came to pass. He was elected. Planes began to rain down on the planet, and the fields were tilled, and the wheat was sown, and Bessie the cow got milked. But not by the people who owned the land, because they were out in the streets trying to figure out what the fuck happened. You know, and isn't it interesting that the homeless now are starting to look more and more like us every second? And it's easy, because we're sitting here, we all got good jobs. We smell good collectively. You know. And things are being done in your government that you may not be aware of. Did you know you could be fired with 6 hours' notice? It's law now. They don't have to give you 2 weeks anymore. Six-day notice. Just interesting stuff. So I don't know what to tell you about what to do, because the election coming up is kind of like pissing in the wind. But you got to do something, because you're entitled to ask for more. You're entitled to ask for more from the country, because it's ours. So do me a favor. Get out there and please vote straight, okay? And remember to ask for what you want, because you can. And if you think about it, it's a good idea, because the country you save may just be your own.
To me.